أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله أحمده تعالى وأستعين به وأستغفره وأستهديه يا رب العالمين. الله Almighty said in Surah Al-Baqarah verse 152 talking about the patience and its reward. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the patience, sabr, in the Holy Quran more than 90 times. Allah mentioned sabr in the Holy Quran. Why 90 times? 9 is enough, 5 is enough, 10 is enough. Why this number? Because I feel the patience or sabr for the Muslimin, the mu'mineen, like the fuel. Without the sabr, we cannot live. Yes, because this dunya, where we live, this worldly life, where we live, full of hardship, problems, too many ups and downs. Subhanallah, spiritually and physically. We are not all the same, we are not equal. Subhanallah, sometimes you feel one day you are very happy. After hours from this happiness, you, subhanallah, you are so sad. One day I'm very healthy, one day I'm very sick, I can't even move my hand. One day I have money, second day I don't have. This is dunya, we're not in Jannah yet. Too many ups and downs. One day you are happy, one day you are very sad. A lot of calamities, strikes from right and left, up and down. But that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I will give you something. Like subhanAllah, when you go to the doctor and that doctor said you are very sick, your body is weak, you have to take some vitamins. And these vitamins, and you eat good food, that vitamins will let you stand again, make your body active, strong again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us that sabr. Why is sabr? He said, as-sabr diya, sabr gives you energy with light. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he described the sun in the Holy Quran and the moon, he talked differently between the sun and the moon. In Surah Yunus, in the chapter of Jonah, Allah said, هو الذي جعل الشمس ضياء والقمر نورا. In English, ضياء and نور means light. Same meaning. But in Arabic, the language of the Holy Quran, Diya is different completely from the Nur. Yes, thank you. Diya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he mentioned Diya, he mentioned it with the sun. When he mentioned the word Nur, light, he mentioned it with the moon. Actually, the moon is so dark. And that light we see it from the moon, it's the reflection of the sun to the moon. That's why it makes light to us on the earth. Means the moon providing just light without energy to you. Just light. That's it. Couple of days during the month. The reflection of the sun to the moon. And the moon itself, it's dark. Subhanallah. But the sun, when Allah said, وَالشَّمْسَ, the sun, ضِيَاءَ. ضِيَاء means what? What did you get from the sun? Light plus energy, the heat. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith, when he said, As-salatu nur, the namaz, the prayer, it is for you like nur, light. Was-sabru, patience, diya. Was-sabru diya. Iba, as-salah, it's a nur for you in your grave, in the above the sirat, in the hereafter, until you go to Jannah. Salah is nur for you. Even nur for you in your life now. When you pray, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is opening your mind and make you like, give you healings, relief. When you pray, you feel like there is, you're very light. You can, mashallah, you are very active. Allah lighten your face and your heart with the salah, with the namaz. Connection between you and Allah, light, nur. But when he said sabr, patience is diya. Diya means what? Light plus energy. That's why any Muslim, any mu'min, when he gets some strikes from right and left or some hardship or calamities, Like what Allah said in the ayah, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. And certainly we will test you with something of little bit of fear, hunger, loss of wealth, lives and fruits. But give glad tidings, O Muhammad, to the patient with delight and happiness in this world and hereafter. This is what Allah said. You will be tested with this little bit of hunger, loss of fruits, loss of anfus, lives, fear, poverty, any strikes, calamities. During that time, as a mu'min, as a Muslim, you think about Allah and patience, sabr. That sabr will let you stand again. You will never drop, you will never fail. Subhanallah, we see, for example, in the Scandinavian countries like Sweden or like Norway or these countries, people, they are so rich there. Most of them, they are now doing nothing. They are sitting home. That's why sometimes they get what? They get tired of what sitting, just sitting like this, doing nothing. Some of them, they execute themselves. Why? Because they have nothing called the sabr. We tried everything in this dunya. Let's try death. They have nothing called sabr. But the Muslim, Allah give us that sabr as hadiyah, as a gift for the Muslim, the mu'min. Before I fell down, I have sabr. Now, Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّ الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بَغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Indeed, those who are patient, they will be rewarded in the hereafter with full reward, without any accountability, from the grave to Jannah. From the grave to Jannah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Oh, you who have believed, seek help from Allah in all of your life through patience and prayer and doing good deeds and forbid evil. Truly, indeed, verily, Allah is with those who are patient from His followers. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Two prescriptions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sabr, salah, namaz. Both of them. If you have both of them, don't worry. Don't worry. Whatever, even all the dunya in fire, Allah will save you like Sayyidina Ibrahim. Don't worry. You are with Allah, connected with Allah. You connect yourself with Allah with what? With salah, namaz. And while you are what? Patient. And without patience, you cannot do even your namaz. Because namaz itself needs sabr, patience. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those, some of the qualities of those who are patient, الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. During your calamity, what you say, some of their qualities, those who are patient, is that when calamity strikes them, they say truly, to Allah we belong and to Him we will return. We will return. This kind of Muslimin, Muslim, mu'min, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them in full reward in dunya and the akhirah. أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة. Look what Allah is saying. أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة. Those are the ones upon whom there are blessings, baraka, salawat from their Lord, Allah, and rahmah, mercy, as well. And those are the ones who are rightly guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now they will be rewarded with three things: blessings, mercy, and they will be guided by Allah. They will get the seal of guidance by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that's why, dear brothers, dear sisters, very important to live your life with patience, sabr. And the sabr, you need it during your calamity. That lady, she came, actually she was sitting beside the grave of her son. Her only son died. She had that only son from this dunya, just one boy. He died, her son. And she was sitting beside his grave, yelling, crying, tearing, saying a lot of words right and left. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, well, the lady was so sad. She did not even recognize Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she was very sad. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her, lady, a nice way, please be patient, sabr. And the lady, because out of her anger, she was sad for her son, who he died. She did not recognize Rasulullah. You know, sometimes when you get mad, you did not recognize anybody around you. Even you can kill somebody. After you kill him, you say, how I did this? I did not know. You know, that lady, she told Rasulullah like this, إِلَيْكَ عَنِّي, go away from me. You don't know what happened to me. إِلَيْكَ عَنِّي, go away. She was telling Rasulullah like this, go away from me. إِلَيْكَ عَنِّي, go away. You don't know what happened to me. Go away. And Rasulullah, he was very quiet, nice, and he left. After she finished, they told her, you was shouting with your hand to Rasulullah. She said, I did that? Did I do that? And she was blaming herself. Where is his house? And she was going to Rasulullah's house to give her apology to Rasulullah. And she said, I did not find any guard beside his door. وَلَمْ أَجِدْ عِنْدَهُ بَوَّابِينَ. This is your prophet. The door is open for everybody. And she said, وَلَمْ أَجِدْ عِنْدَهُ بَوَّابِينَ. There was no guard beside his door. I just entered. And I told him, Ya Rasulullah, I am very sorry. I did not recognize you. I am very sorry, Ya Rasulullah. Please forgive me. And Rasulullah told her, إِنَّمَا الصَّبْرُ عند الصدمة الأولى. When the strike comes, you have to be patient from the beginning, not now. You see, some people, they cut their clothes and they say bad words and they say astaghfirullah even against Allah. When they lose somebody they love or whatever, they say a lot of bad stuff, haram stuff, for guna yani. And then when they do everything, and when they become quiet, what happened? They say astaghfirullah inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. No, you have to say that from the beginning. And the sadmat al-ula, when the strike comes, from the beginning you have to say inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. This is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her. Sabr is very important. We need it. We need sabr when we come and do our namaz and the prayer. When we fast Ramadan, we need sabr when you go to Hajj. We need sabr when you make any kind of act of worship. You need sabr. We need it in our life. You need it during our sickness, calamity. When we lose somebody we love, we need sabr. We need sabr even to be away from shaitan rajim. You know, shaitan is telling you, go disobey Allah, go this, do this haram. Call it sabr an al-ma'asiyah, to be away from al-ma'asiyah or the sin, or being disobedient to Allah. You need sabr too. Otherwise, sabr means what in Arabic? Sabr means control, habs al-nafs, to control your soul, your nafs, from doing haram and to do good. This is the sabr, habs al-nafs, control. And that's why we have the Sharia law system. It's a system, and we're being controlled as Muslims by Sharia law. Otherwise, those who are outside, you can do like them, imitate them, it's okay. But it's, for us, it's not okay, because laysa ba'da al-kufri dhanb. After disbelief, there is no sin. Do whatever you want. Somebody is not fasting in the month of Ramadan during the daytime, and he's eating, drinking publicly like this in the street, and you tell him, brother, haram, we're in Ramadan. He's going to tell you, brother, I'm not Muslim. Excuse me, I'm sorry. See, because he's not Muslim, do whatever you want. But because you take the title, I'm a Muslim, no. You have to be controlled by now. We have Sharia law, we have to follow the system of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, you're out. But that's why we have to be patient. Sabr, I know it's sour, it's not good, but the end of it, sweeter than honey. Yes, sabr, because you're going to see the reward. Allah, you're going to enjoy it. You're going to say, Alhamdulillah, Allah give me sabr. And Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, I passed the test, and Allah examined me, and Alhamdulillah, I am okay now. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا يا رب العالمين.